Well, 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 what have we here, folks? I guarantee you're not going to see one of these pull in your driveway anytime soon unless you buy this one. What do you think?
This thing's killer, man. You know, I don't think we've ever had one of these through the shop.
Well, we haven't had one that ran, that's for sure. This is a 51-year-old 1968 100% bone stock 125 Harley Davidson that Junior just rolled up on. Absolutely a museum piece. Oh, I forgot to introduce ourselves. Hey, it's Ken Kaplan from the New England Motorcycle Museum. How you doing? Do a walk around. Take a close look at this thing. This bike is 100% bone stock original. It's got the coolest sounding horn I've ever heard on a motorcycle. Sounds like something should be on our 200-year-old elevator inside the museum, but this is a Harley Davidson M125 manufactured by Armaki for Harley Davidson.
It's a Rapido model.
Rapido.
125.
M125, Rapido. 1968, that makes it, it's like what, 51 years old?
51 years old.
Everything works beautifully on it. The bike is in 100%, right down to the tires, original condition, with only 913 miles. This came from the Clint Lauren collection. He's one of the Harley Owner Group, Thousand Island Harley Owner Group members. We'll put a link to his video in the description so you can get an idea who owned this bike. He's one of the... Yeah, absolutely. He's a veteran Harley Davidson aficionado who donated a whole huge load of Harley Davidson collectibles to the museum. We told him the bikes would have to be sold. To raise funds. We can't keep it. We wish we could, unless you want to buy it and leave it on display. I have a work order. We went right through the bike. We put about a $1,500 investment in the bike between shipping it from Canada, the Canadian border down to here, and a total of 7 hours of service. And 6 hours in a detail shop. This whole thing was polished clean top to bottom, every piece on it, and the work order shows 13 hours total labor, only $45 in parts. It really didn't need anything for parts. We just put a new fuel line on it, some gear oil, some rubber mounts for the front of the fuel tank, and a new dual filament 6-volt tail bulb. So total investment in parts was $37.75. so really didn't need anything. So first thing we did when we got the bike in, Clint said it was a good running bike. So we went through, checked the cylinder compression, checked out at a perfect 120 PSI. The spark was good, had a clean plug in it. We did remove and replace the carburetor after we did a complete clean and adjust on the carb. It has two air filters. Show them the dual air filter setup on this thing, Kenny.
I didn't even notice that until you said
it's got a dual clamshell original 51-year-old air filter box. It's in perfect condition. Cleaned the original. I think they're probably replacement air filters. They're in good condition. We just cleaned them. Put brand new gear oil on it. We did remove the front wheel to clean and lube the brake cam and clean the drum and shoes so that the whole front brake assembly on the front end was pulled off. We lubricated all the cables and adjusted them, set the tire pressures, and did some research. These are, in fact, the original tires. Do some close-ups on the tires, Kenny. I think it's pretty remarkable that these are the original Pirellis, as denoted by Mark, our senior motorcycle restoration guy here at the museum. Original Pirellis with 900 miles, and they look like in excellent condition. Just remarkable. The drive chain is the original chain. Show them the chain, Kenny. We just cleaned it and checked the adjustment and lubed it. We removed the fuel tank that after we did those other things, and we drained the fuel that Clint had in there. It was probably last year's fuel. We disassembled and cleaned the petcock and test and checked to make sure that was okay. You can see the petcock's in mint condition. The inside of the tank was cleaned with our soda blast method. The interior of the tank was clean. Look at the inside of this tank, Kenny. It's like it just came out of the Harley Davidson factory in 1968. Good luck finding a cleaner original tank. This is not a coated tank. This is original. The paint job is in excellent condition. This is the original factory paint on this bike. What else can I tell you? The fuel tank was installed. They did put a new fuel line on there. It's a rubber fuel line. They put a brand new one on and checked it for leaks. So absolutely no leaks. Start and ran the bike, set the idle speed, tested all the lights, the brake light, the horn, and the kill switch. Everything works perfectly. This bike, no, you need to note this. This bike has no ignition switch or key. It never did. That's how it came from the factory 51 years ago. And also has no battery. So you don't have to ever worry about losing the key. You don't ever have to worry about the battery. So pretty fantastic little machine. The test ride, Kenny's been ripping it around. It sounds like the engine sounds like a brand new motor, and it seems to shift beautifully.
You know, so I think it started second kick stone cold for us just now, and I was ripping it around, but Mark did some testing on it, and he noted that, well, basically we're having an issue with the transmission, essentially, where you have to get going.
No, not the transmission, the clutch, because he said the clutch wasn't. It shifts fine and goes through all the gears beautifully. There's nothing wrong with the transmission.
Right,
he thinks that the clutch plates may need to be replaced. The original fibers may have deteriorated because they're 51 years old.
Yep.
So it won't pull a load up a hill very well. But the crank is perfect. The cylinder is perfect. The carburetor exhaust is perfect. And the transmission shifts through all the gears beautifully on a stand, which he performed that test, put it in gear and ran it through all the gears in the stand. The only problem is it won't take a real heavy load. I know you were able to bring it up the hill here, but
yeah, you just got to get a running start and then she rips.
So he thought it was probably a clutch pack.
Exactly.
So in any event, you can call for clarification on that. Our phone number is 860-454-7024 if you have any questions. Take a close look. Handlebars are original. Mirrors original. The Harley Davidson branded grips, the original white grips, the original rubbers on the foot pegs and the shifter are in beautiful shape. These are the items that normally deteriorate. Usually the bikes are dropped and things are get dent or bented or rusted. This is an original. There's a little bit of patina on the chrome, on the rims, and there has been a little bit of a rust preventative coating put on, I believe there was a little rust preventative coating, like a Rust-Oleum or something, put on a couple of the spokes, but I can't really confirm that. I'm not a scientist, but it looks like there may have been some put on there. So that's about it. Kenny, is there anything you want to add? Before you say anything, I want to close in by saying, when I saw this thing roll in, I'm not a real fan of most of the small bore vintage Harleys, but I kind of fell in love with this one off Jump Street, and I said, you know, I want to hang on to this one and put it in the museum. In the restaurant bar on the first floor on one of the Harley Davidson lifts we have. So I'd love to see it stay here, but that's all I got to say. And other than that, the original upholsteries, and look at the seat on this thing. It's just a work of art. And go ahead, Junior. What do you want to say?
So we can get it shipped really affordably. We deal with private shippers, DOT licensed, insured, enclosed transport. Smaller bikes, they'll cut you a deal. Message us your postal code for a quote.
What do you think about the styling? You'd mentioned the tank you thought looked like the Baja 100.
It's all about the lines. You see the, for example, the other Air Machis, like with the rounded tanks from...
Yeah, show them from the angle, like down here.
Yeah, like from the mid-70s, the styling, those bikes, they haven't really popped yet because the...
They have like round-looking tanks. This is more edgy cafe style, you know? Look at the lines of this tank, the way it comes straight up in the back and flattens out. It's got the flat black racing stripe with the white pinstripes and then the gloss.
Man. That's a classic.
The seat, the flat black matches the seat perfectly. The original silver in the Air Machi sticker on the back, the tie-in sticker. Just a beautiful piece. So good luck finding a nicer one, a nicer original one. I haven't seen one in all my years at Daytona and all the vintage shows we go to. We're an ambassador site for the Antique Motorcycle Club of America. We have vintage bike shows here. You just don't see these bikes show up in original.
We get dozens of leads, bike leads, in our inbox on a weekly basis, or maybe even daily.
And about 50 used bikes, vintage bikes show up here a month, and very rarely you're going to see a 51-year-old one original like this in mint shape.
Like I said, I don't believe we've ever had one through the shop. If we have, it hasn't been running.
Well, we've had truckloads, literally truckloads of our Machis through our shop, and just check on our site, on our YouTube site, under Harley Davidson 100, 125, 175, and 250, you'll see dozens of them, and none of them are in this kind of shape, except for, we did do a frame-up restoration on a 250 that sold for over $5,000, a 75 250 SX.
Right.
That was beautiful, but it was a cucumber that turned into a pickle that we turned back into a cucumber. It wasn't original, you know? Like, this is original. This is the original cucumber, unmolested, virgin showpiece, a work of art, so.
In closing, it's the nicest for sale today. You will not find a nicer one for sale.
Absolutely.
Today, and perhaps for several months to come.
I've never kickstarted it yet. Junior started. Said it started second kick for him.
It'll kick first right now. It's warm.
Listen to this thing. Listen to the exhaust note on this. Purrs like a kitten. Where are you going to find a horn like that? Just awesome.
There's not much to say, guys, you know? So, look at the photos, look at the video. I mean,
If you got any questions, give us
a call. This thing's definitely a Captain America approved bike for sure. I'd sell this to a friend or family member with confidence that it's a rock solid investment. So good luck bidding on it. It's going to go up in value. God bless America for bringing in kick-ass bikes like this.